if you have maybe a pre-existing condition, and that's something that you really need to discuss with your doctor before you start working out. But that's important, Brian, to know, because if you have hypertension or if you have diabetes or who knows, I mean, heart disease, the list can go on and on, right?
Yes.
But those pre-existing conditions are important that you talk to your doctor about before you start, you know, pumping away.
Yeah. The whole thing, the American College of Sports Medicine developed like these guidelines prior to exercise back in the day, and still to this day, just to avoid what's called myocardial infarction or sudden cardiac death during exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, it's very rare, but some people go and exercise, get a heart attack, and then they pass.
Exactly.
So to prevent that, they created like these little steps that you can check ahead of time, and they've made some changes to the guidelines, but everything's still, they still have those self-screening guides to help people who don't have a trainer to go with.
And what are some of those self-screening tools, if you wish, if you will, to determine if you're ready?
So it's the Park Q Plus.
Park Q Plus. And,
yeah.
And I'm glad you brought it up, because when you hear Park, you think P-A-R-K.
This is...
But it's P-A-R-Q Plus.
Yeah.
So take it away. What is
that? So the Park Q Plus is a questionnaire. It's a three-page questionnaire, but you only really have to answer seven, and you only do the two additional pages if you answered yes to the first seven. So it asks you questions like, do you have lower back pain? Do you have a heart condition? Have you ever had a heart attack? Just ask you seven questions, yes or no. And if you answered no to all of them, it'll tell you, hey, you're good to exercise under moderate and low-intensity physical activity things if you have no pre-existing condition, and then you can build your way up to a vigorous program. If you answer yes to any of those questions, they have some follow-up questions to better explore what's going on. And based on that, it'll tell you, it has like a little algorithm, and it'll tell you, hey, if you answered yes to these questions, go to your doctor before you exercise just to make sure it's safe. If you answered yes to these questions, you might be okay to do moderate and low. But it kind of gives them a guide to figure out whether, hey, is it safe enough for me to do exercise? Sometimes if you have an orthopedic concern, it's still safe for you to do exercise. You just have to modify.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a pre-existing metabolic condition, it may not be safe.